Yeah, or yes, is defined as the following. Again, we have the diameter of the optical transceiver. Then we have 4 theta s squared multiplied by l squared. Again, we have these two parameters. The opt and the atmosphere. Okay? It is important to point out that this formula, for this relation, is true even if we have polarization of light at the corner cube, so the spot of the laser at the corner cube is bigger than the corner cube, and then also what is sent back to the receiver is again bigger than the receiver. Okay, if we have two polarizations from the corner cube and from the optic at the receiver, this formula holds. Okay? So this formula holds for a situation in which we don't have polarization of light at the corner cube, so all the light that goes to the target is reflected back, this is the first part, or this relation is also true if we have polarization here at the target and here at the receiver. If we have polarization at the corner cube only, we have a second relation that says that we can use the cooperative target that says that, let's call this way, this is simply given by the diameter of the corner cube divided by theta s squared m squared, and again we have the optical and the atmosphere. This is true when theta s multiplied by l is higher than the diameter of the cone. Okay? So these are the three possibilities that you will encounter in this during this course. Okay? Now let's start to put some number inside this formula. For example, let's start with a non-cooperative target, so with a diffuse one. The hypothesis that the transmission of the optic is perfect, so we have one. We want to measure a distance that is equal to 50 meters. The diffusivity of the target is 0.5. The diameter, the diameter of the optic of the receiver is 30 millimeters. And, there is another parameter. The attenuation length of the atmosphere is 0.5 kilometers minus 1. And, okay, we have everything. Then, what we get, in particular, we get that the attenuation of the atmosphere for this value and for this value of alpha and for this value of length is given by 0.95. So attenuation of air does not play a great role in this case. And then the full calculation, we have all the number, gives 4.3 10 to minus 8. Okay? This is just a calculation. We can also call this number attenuation, because this is an attenuation. Okay? Okay. Then, now, let's try to understand what is the power that we need at the source if, for example, the noise, the power related to the noise that we have at the receiver is equal to 0.1 nanowatt. Now, if this is the noise that we have at the receiver, what is the value that we must have at the source? How can you answer this question? This is an open question, of course, because what is important is what is the signal-to-noise ratio with which I can work. Okay, so this is the point. In an easy way, we can say, okay, let's suppose that we are able to work with a minimum power at the receiver that is exactly equal to the power of the noise, related to the noise. So what does it mean? That here we work with a signal to noise ratio equal to 1. Okay, this is an hypothesis. This is simplifying the calculation. See? Okay, so what we have is that the power of the source is equal to what? Is equal to the power of the noise under this condition divided by the attenuation or the value that we have just calculated. Okay? So under this condition we have that we need at least 2.34 milliwatt at the source. Okay? So even if we have let's say a high value attenuation and we have the ability to work with a very low value of noise, we can work with a very low value of the power emitted by the source. 2.3, 2.34 milliwatt is a good value, especially for visible light. So we can use this value with the high condition of security, okay, related to the laser. Okay. This is not dangerous for the eye. If you look at the red light, a red laser, with this power, this is not dangerous for the air. This is the idea. Okay? Okay, so this is what happened under this condition with a non-cooperative target. Now let's start to say, okay, now we will change from a diffusive target to a corner cube. And let's try to evaluate what is the gain in length that we can achieve if this value remains constant. Okay, so we fix the attenuation and then let's say, okay, but using a corner cube, how much far I can go with this system? Let's put us in the condition in which we don't have parcelization of light at the corner cube. So, in particular, we have, let's call, this is the length with the corner cube or with the cooperative target. And we want that this power budget is exactly the same that we have just evaluated. Okay? So we can write this as B multiplied by the square value of the diameter of the optic for this length is the non-cooperative length or the 50 meter stress. Write it here, non-cooperative. Okay. Multiply by, again, of course, the opt, even if this is equal to 1, and the atmosphere. Okay? Now we want to evaluate what is this value. And we will try to understand how much larger is this value with respect to the starting one. Okay? Okay. Four. Okay. Okay, let's try to solve the problem without, for that matter, this is equal to 1, so we can cancel out this. And let's try to cancel out also the attenuation of the atmosphere. Now we will see if this is correct or not. Okay? So if this is the working condition that we have, what we find? We find that the distance with a cooperative target is equal to this quantity is given by the value that we have already evaluated. And so what we have the non-cooperative distance multiplied by what? Multiplied by 1 over theta s squared. You need a value that is the full divergence angle of the source, and this is given by 2 mean lead drag. And we have the diffusivity coefficient. Okay, so that we have this relation. Okay, and in particular, this quantity can give to you the gain in length that we achieve, that we can achieve. So what we have is equal to non-cooperative distance multiplied more or less by 707. Okay? So starting with 50 meters of measuring distance, we can go to 35 more or less kilometers. Now, is this correct or not? Because when we say, okay, we cannot consider the attenuation of the atmosphere, well, this is not exact. Okay? Because now, if you try to understand what happens with 35 kilometers and a coefficient that is 0.5 kilometers to minus 1, you have a terrific attenuation of the atmosphere, in the atmosphere. And in particular, what you get is that E to minus 2 alpha L cooperative is equal to four 0.4 10 to minus 16. 10 to minus 16. Okay? So this is not equal to 0.95. Okay? So you cannot avoid the attenuation of the atmosphere. And if you go back here, this is, of course, again given by the attenuation quantity that we have just evaluated, but here we must use the full formula. Okay? This is the point. So now, how can you solve the problem? To find out what is the real distance that you can work with a cooperative target, because this calculation is wrong. Because now, if we follow this calculation, we have a distance that gives an attenuation coefficient of the atmosphere that is too high. Okay. How can you solve this? Or how can you go close to the solution of the problem? Okay. Because the problem is that here we have an equation that is a transcendental equation. Okay? So you cannot solve by hand. Okay? You can have an idea if you use, for example, or when you say, for example, that you have dr divided by 4 theta s squared and c squared, and this is equal to a 2 of l multiplied by that equation. Okay? Because these are two equation or two curves, then if you use then you have an exponential form. So here we have the length, okay? So you have something that is goes like this. This is e 2 of lc multiplied by attenuation, okay? And then this formula is something that goes like this. Then this is the solution, okay? Now when you do when you try to solve an equation in this way, you have to pay attention to the unit of measure of the length. Since you have here kilometers to minus 1, you have to use kilometers also here. Okay, so pay attention to this. But anyway, this is what happens in reality. This is an image of this intersectional point. And so what you get is that LC, the correct value of LC is 4.272 kilometers. Okay? So now, what does it do? That if we work with a cooperative target and we can sustain an attenuation that is equal to the original value, so 4.3 × 10⁻⁸, we can go from 50 meters to 4.2 kilometers. So we have a gain in length. Okay? With the same value, of course, of the emitted power. This is the point. So we have more or less 2 milliwatt of power emitted by the source, and we can measure distances as far as 4 kilometers. A good point. Okay? Okay. Now, let's try to understand how difficult was for the NASA guys to measure the distance between Earth and Moon with a balanced interferometer. You can also think of this as a proof that a human has gone to the Moon. Because during one of the mission, of the Apollo mission, they put three corner cubes on the surface of the Moon, and then they have used this corner cube to measure the distance per Moon. Because the concept is very easy. I mean, this is a time of flight measurement. But the difficulty of the measure is quite high. Because what you have, the distance is more or less, this is just to simplify the calculation, given by 400,000 kilometers. This is the distance between the Earth and the Moon. the optic of the receiver is 1 meter, well, the diameter of the optic of the receiver is 1 meter. The divergence, the full divergence of the laser source is a good one, it is 1 millirad. But let's try to work in a condition in which the attenuation of the atmosphere is not so great. So let's use 0.1 kilometers to minus 1. Okay? both the optic of the receiver and of the source are good, so that the transmission of the optic is equal to 1. Have you got all the data, or do you need one more information to proceed with the calculation? Because our goal is to try to solve the power budget again. And this is given by F squared 4 theta S squared a length squared and the optic multiplied by the atmosphere. Okay. Now, in this calculation, should I use the full distance or something else? I want to go to the moon. So the attenuation of the atmosphere is just in the atmosphere, okay? So I need to give to you, let's say, the thickness of the atmosphere. This is more or less equal to 20 kilometers. And so in particular, this is the full distance. This is okay. But in particular, here we have to use E minus 2 half L atmosphere. Okay. And what we have is that this value is equal to, if we consider a very clear day, is equal to 0.018. Okay? And we have all the other numbers. So this is equal to 2.86 10 to minus 14. Okay? So what does it mean? That the attenuation is very high, of course, and that more or less we receive 3 photons for more than 100,000 billion that we sent to the moon. So, in principle, the idea is very simple, time of flight measurement. But then, the attenuation of this measurement is very high. Okay. In particular, we have done the calculation with a very clear day. But if we change, I suppose we use another parameter that is 0.2, so still a good condition, this number became 0.052 10 to minus 14. Okay? Anyway, what was the idea of this calculation? Even we can work with rangefinder based on pulse telemeter, even if the attenuation is very high. Okay? Things works. And in particular, until some years ago, there was a microsite on the NASA website in which you can do the calculation. There was a button and you were able to do the calculation. Okay? But anyway, this is just to give you an idea that in particular we can work with such high distances. This is the point. And again, of course, I have used the same formula as before, simply because of course we have pasteurization of light at the corner Q on the moon and then back to her. Okay? This is why I'm using this calculation. Okay? Okay.
It means that the corner cube on the moon was large at least half a meter.
One meter.
One on the moon.
Yes, on the
moon. Was at least half a meter.
Yes.
Because on the receiver 1 meter, otherwise it was cutting
of course
the corner cube.
Yes, that's true. Well, the spot on the moon is very high. It's very big. I mean, if you do a calculation, Then, the spot of the laser of the moon is given by theta s multiplied by the distance, and this gives to you this is the diameter of the beam on the moon, and this is equal to 4×10⁵ meters, so we have a big spot. Okay. And okay, we can go on with a review of pulsed and continuous wave telemeters, their basic characteristics. In particular, let's consider first the pulsed telemeter. Okay. The idea is to measure the time of flight, that is given by 2L divided by C. Okay. So what does it mean? That the distance is equal to time of flight multiplied by C over 2, where C is the velocity of light. Okay. So this is the very easy formula for the time of flight telemeters. In particular, with this formula, what we can say, we can say that the resolution on the measurement is simply related to the resolution of time measurement that we are able to do. So this resolution is given by C over 2 multiplied by the resolution of the timing measurement that we are able to do. And this is an absolute value. I mean, it is not this resolution does not depend on the distance, okay? But simply on our ability of measuring time. Okay. This is an important point of the time of flight telemeters. With respect, for example, to the continuous wave or modulation telemeter. Okay. Here what we have. We have a continuous wave, a continuous emitting laser that is modulated by a sinusoidal waveform. Okay. And in particular, we read the information of the distance on the phase of this modulation. Okay? So I never remember the formula with memory, but you can simply relate the time of flight to the period of the modulation, like the phase is related to the full phase of the wave. Okay. Sorry. And then in particular, what you get is that again, 2L over C is related to the 1 over f modulation phase to power, so that the distance L is equal to C divided by 2 multiplied by 1 over 2 pi f modulation and the phase. Okay? This is correct? Yes, okay, this is correct. Okay, so again, what is the resolution of this instrument with respect to the pulsed telemeter? We can write it here. DL that is given by C over 2, 1, 2 by F modulation multiplied by the resolution.